I used ChatGPT to write a supporting information or what we term as a supporting statement for UK nursing job for a friend. And just yesterday, she called and said she has been shortlisted for an interview. It did work. All right, so in this video, I'm going to share with you how to write a very good supporting statement with the help of ChatGPT. Have you heard of ChatGPT before? If you haven't, don't worry. I'm going to show you how to write a supporting statement within the shortest minute possible, 5 minutes, and you can apply for as many UK nursing jobs you can. So if you are interested, why don't you come with me as we look at that. If today is your first time seeing my channel, my name is Stark Watchman, and you can simply call me Kobe. And I know for sure that you have not subscribed to this channel yet, so please hit the subscribe button right under this video, then become part of the family. Per my YouTube statistics, YouTube has shown me that most people watch my videos don't subscribe. Please subscribe because I do my best to bring you the best of content I can. Before I start, I must say that this video is an upgraded version of a video I made some time ago, so you can see that running on the screen. So that video was about how to write a very good supporting statement, but there you are going to use your own mind to write that. But in these videos, we are going to use an artificial intelligence known as ChatGPT. So as you can see on the screen here, this is how the ChatGPT looks like. So it's like a human robot. Ask any question you would want to ask, and this system will tell you the answer. But then it's not 100% accurate most of the times, but just get to know that whatever question you are asking, you have a fair idea of it, so at the end of the day, whatever answer you get, you'll be able to tell as to whether it is what you are looking out for or not. Okay, so most students are using this, most people are using this to write their CVs, to write supporting statements, but my purpose here is to show you how to do it the right way. So what can you put in here so that at the end of the day you are able to get a CV or a supporting statement that is in line with the job you are searching for? Remember the saying that not one fits, or what this means is that you can't use just one CV or one supporting statement to apply for UK nursing jobs. That won't work. Remember that every employer has got their different values, their different job description or job roles you are looking out for. So if you write one supporting statement based on employer A and then use that for employer B to Z, then that won't help. What this means is that you may do a lot of applications and you'll not be shortlisted for any interview. So how do you write a supporting statement or a very good CV with ChatGPT? You know, one may ask, what is a supporting statement? When we say a supporting statement is similar to a CV on track.jobs. What is track.jobs? It's one of the UK nursing job search platforms. So when you go on there, you see a lot of UK nursing jobs. NHS hospitals have put their vacancies there, and then they are expecting you to apply if you need them or if you want to fit in one of those roles. When you get on track jobs and you want to apply for any nursing job to an NHS hospital, you need to create an online CV. Now, in the course of creating the online CV, there's a portion that says supporting statements. Now, when you get to that point, you're going to write 1,500 words on the topic about your professional summary, your educational background, the skills and interests you share, your references while you're applying to that NHS hospital, and some relevant information about you that may put you ahead of other applicants. Now, before you start writing a very good supporting statement, you should make sure that you have landed on an NHS job. So I'm going to search for a job on track jobs or wherever, and then we try to see how best we can tell our supporting statement to make sure that at least we are getting what we want. So let's go and search for UK nursing jobs. That's the first thing. So good enough, we found a UK nursing job. So this is coming from one of the NHS trusts in the UK, James Paget University Hospitals NHS Foundation Trust. So I have realized that this trust is recruiting international nurses, and I have interest in applying for the job role. So the question is, how do I go about this? How do I write my supporting statement? If you are new to track jobs, first of all, you have to create an account. I've made a complete video about how to apply for jobs on track jobs. Okay, so I'll leave the link in the description box. Check that one out. I won't be able to take you through every process because this video can't contain us. So this is the job I found, as I said, and you're going to write a supporting statement using ChatGPT. To write a very good supporting statement, there are some ingredients you need to add. Let's look at those ingredients and then we'll come back to look at the thing you have to do once you land on a job. Alright, so as you can see on here, this is the skeleton of a very good supporting statement. In my previous video, I explained each one of these, so I'm not going to do that. If you want to watch that video, I'll leave the link in the description box as well. Take time and then watch it, okay? Because whatever energy you put in here will be reciprocated, and that is, you'll be shortlisted for an interview if you do things right. Okay, so now that you know the skeleton of a very good supporting statement, I would want to prove to you that all these important stuff that you are seeing on here are relevant. So let's go back to track jobs and then look at the section where you have to put your supporting statement, and then we look at what they are expecting from you, so that we just compare that to what we have on here to see if they are relevant or not. Alright, so this is the point where you have to write the supporting statement, okay? And when you come down here, it says you have to write a maximum of 1500 words. It doesn't necessarily mean you should write this number of words, but whatever number of words you are writing, you should make sure that the relevant information are included in there. So if you're writing 500 words, make sure that whatever they are expecting from you is in there. If you're writing 200 words, make sure that whatever they expect from you is in there. If you're writing all the 1500, make sure whatever they are expecting from you is in there as well. As I said, we are going to compare the skeleton I showed you to what they are expecting from you, as you can see. In this session, you need to demonstrate that you have read the published person specification and how you meet the essential and, where relevant, desirable criteria for the particular post you are applying for. If this has not been fully covered in the previous sessions, please include your reasons for applying. So remember, we had the reason for applying. So just as you are seeing on the screen, we had a reason for applying to this hospital. Then take the opportunity to highlight your particular talent and strength. Remember, we have our talent and strength on there as well. What you feel you can personally offer? What can you offer to the NHS hospital once they give you the opportunity to join them? So you have to include that as well. What is unique to you? And then what sets you apart from your peers? What makes you so unique and different that when they give you the job, apparently you'll be exceptional? You have to include that as well. And then there's a note that says, please do not include personal details or duplicate information already provided elsewhere in your application. So you can see that whatever we have on the skeleton, or probably the document I showed you, is what they are looking out for. Okay, so you have to make sure that as you write a supporting statement, each one of these is captured in the supporting statement. So I'll leave the template down there. If you want to download it, that's fine. I mean, you can just go by it. All right, so now you're going back. Now that you know that whatever information I said on there is very relevant to writing a supporting statement, we are going to look at the next thing. So this is the hospital I'm going to apply to. Now they are looking for international staff nurse for a band 5 role. And then when you come on here, it says, are you an internationally trained nurse? Have you passed your CBT and IELTS and need support with your OSCE? If so, then we have a job for you. But remember that there are some of the NHS trusts that will say if you are coming from this country or that country, you can apply and a whole lot of that. But I'm just doing this video in general. So what we are going to do is that we are going to copy this statement and then we input it into ChatGPT. So let's do that. So before you paste whatever you copied from there, there's something you have to do. We are going to ask this AI a very intelligent question. And the question is, can you write me a supporting statement for a UK nursing job application at an NHS hospital with the following information provided? So watch me put that question in here. So at this point, we are going to paste the first information we copied, which has to do with the CBT IELTS stuff. Okay, so let's paste. And then we'll go back to the job vacancy here. And the next thing we're going to do is that basically there are two ways to this. You can read the information on here and then pick the important ones and then put them in ChatGPT, or you can go down here and then download the job description and then the person specification, so you get all the relevant information they are expecting from you or in relation to the job you are applying for. You are going to feed this in ChatGPT, so you can see that this artificial intelligence would write out a very good supporting statement involving the relevant information the hospital is looking out for, is seeking from you. Now the reason why you have to do this is because you have to make sure that whatever keyword in here is inscribed in your supporting statement, and the reason is because of the reason robot I talked about. Probably what happened is that when there are so many job applications, your supporting statement or CV will be fed into the reason robot or the ATS. Now what happens here is that the ATS will be picking out all the CVs or supporting statements that go in line with what the hospital is looking out for, and then mostly they will feed the reason robot with keywords. For example, so when you come up on here, there are keywords that has to do with the fact that, you know, have you passed your CBT and then meet your skill support. That may be one of the keywords. Now when you scroll down here, they've also said some skills you need to have to be able to apply to this job role: ability to work as part of a team, good organizational and team building skills, accurate documents presentation and attention to details, IT skills. So all this important information should be included in your supporting statement, so that on the day, the resume robot won't surpass it. This is one way they are able to sideline some supporting statement or CVs from the others. The resume robot helps cut down the number of applications, so that on the day, the employer can easily glance through the remaining ones. I'm going to download the job description as the first document, and then later download the person specification. Okay, so when you come on here, it says that behavioral skills, main duties and responsibilities, they have all been outlined here. We've got other important stuff like personal issues, health and safety responsibilities. You can see that there's a whole lot of stuff on here, the hospital's values and other important stuff. So you have to make sure that you're including all of this in your supporting statement. So you can let the system write the individual skeletons, like the professional summary. Once you are done with that, you allow it to write the key roles, the strength and talent and everything. Probably the question is, how do you want it? All right, so now that we have the job description, what we are going to do is that we're going to copy all this stuff and then give it to ChatGPT to do its work. Okay, so let's copy, then we give that to ChatGPT and let's say paste. So let's keep a semicolon, then we are going to copy the rest to say, so here it's basically talking about the main duties you'll be asked to perform. You copy that as well, then go and then put that in ChatGPT, just as you are seeing. Now the importance of this is that ChatGPT will write a supporting statement for you, including all the relevant keywords. So you wouldn't have to worry yourself too much. And basically, after every write-up, you have to sit back and then categorize them under the skeletons I showed you. Okay, and that is not very difficult at all. I'll demonstrate that for you to see as well. Okay, so I'm going to copy the professional issues. I can copy all at once just to save time. Okay, and then let's go to ChatGPT. Okay, we'll give a semicolon and then we go back on there and see other responsibilities they want us to perform are that. For now, you can't really tell which keyword will be fed into the vision robot, so to be on the safer side, you just have to make sure that at least you are covering up important stuff. Let's copy from infection control down to the trust values. Now we are done with the job description, so the next thing you have to do is to go and download the person specification. So here they are looking at your education and qualifications, they are looking at a degree, whether you have a degree, I mean all those stuff should be included on there. Then your skills, so this is very, very important. So now this will help you on the part of the skills and interest. So here it says we're starting with education qualifications, and we're just going to copy that. Let's copy everything in here. Alright, so back in here, you can see that they are expecting you to put out the skills and abilities and competencies as well as behavioral qualities. All these things should be included in your supporting statement. Okay, so now I have successfully copied everything. Now what we're going to do is that we're just going to allow ChatGPT to do its work. So all you have to do is to just click on this green option on here and then let's see what happens. So, alright, so this is the first part of it. So what we're going to do is that we're going to copy ChatGPT in its own wisdom has given you the topics, but that is not what you are looking out for. So what happens here is that we just copy this, we copy every one of these things on here, and then put it on a blank Microsoft Word document, and then I'll show you the next thing to do once this is done. All right, so we're going to copy that. Copy. Let's go and create a new document, then we are going to paste. So now this is it. So this is 703 words. As I said, we're going to edit this and then put the information right where they belong. But let's say I'm not convinced with this. I just need more of this so I know that I'll be able to pick up which ones I want and then fix them under this skeleton. Now you can see here that most of the stats you are looking out for can be found in here. But I still think ChatGPT can do better than this. As I said, before you use this system, make sure that whatever information that is being written, at least you have a fair idea of it so that when we are given the answer, you'll be able to tell us to whether it's what is we are looking out for or not. We haven't read this yet, but let's go and then generate a new answer with ChatGPT. So you just come on here and say regenerate response. I'm just going to copy just as I did for the previous ones. Copy and then we'll go and paste. I'm going to paste. Good. So based on the information we have on here, we go through each one of them and then put them under the right headings. Now, what I'm going to do here is that we're going to see if the necessary keywords we are looking out for which we consulted ChatGPT is in any one of these statements we have been given. So now that you have gathered all the information you need to make up a meaning, the next thing to do is the editing phase. Okay, so we are going to put this information under the right headings to make sense. Now, how do you do this? I'm going to do this in my next video. So here, you'll be able to write supporting statement within the shortest possible time, lay them out properly, and then send it out to the employer. Supporting statement or online CV will successfully pass through the resume robot and then get to the employer. If this video has been very helpful, I know that it will help others as well. So why don't you share, why don't you like, so that at least it can reach so many people who are seeking to apply for EK Nursing jobs but are struggling to write supporting statements.